formulators. I am Elham from Skin Chakra, the place where you can purchase excellent quality cosmetic raw material and where you can learn how to formulate like a cosmetic chemist, even if you are not one. As I have already promised, I am going to give you a few tips about purchasing and using scales in your formulation lab. Scales are among the most important assets in your lab, and if you purchase the right one or the suitable one, they work for an eternity and there is no need to replace them. Usually it is better, or you cannot cover all of your needs with just one scale, and you need to purchase a couple of scales that you can cover a broad range of weights and precisions, but we'll come to that. So it's usually cheaper and better to have two, three scales instead of one scale with a very broad range. But you need to know about the scales before you even start to purchase. Although the terms scales and balances are usually exchange and interchange, historically balances are used for these type of, you know, two pan instruments that you really literally balance when you weigh. These are old-fashioned instruments that you may see in museums nowadays. And scales are used for more modern instruments, but the terms are very often exchanged and interchanged. The most important factors that you have to consider when you want to purchase scales or balances are the capacity and the precision. The capacity of the scale is the maximum weight than the scale can show you before it goes to error message. So it's quite different. It varies between 10 gram to tons. So depending on your batch size and on your workflow, you have to decide which one you want. Here I have several scales with different capacities. This one, I think it's about 600 gram. This one is about 3 kilogram. This one is for 20 kilogram. So depending on the batch size that you have, you may want to have one or the other one. Just keep in mind that your container is considered with the weight as well. So if you have a balance with a 300 gram capacity and your beaker weighs 100 grams, so the maximum that you can weigh is practically 200 gram and not 300 grams. So what you use as the container and you tear your balance with that is still taking from your capacity. The other thing that you have to consider is that the nominal capacity is always higher than the actual capacity. So if your balance is 300 gram, you probably can go to 250, 280 grams, but not higher than that. These two factors should be considered. Another important factor is the precision. The precision is the tiniest amount that your balance can measure. So it could be a milligram, a tenth of a milligram, a hundredth of a gram, 10 gram, depending on the scale's capacity as well. Usually the higher the capacity and the higher the precision of the scales, the higher the price. So if you are not working in an analytical lab and you are making just some usual skincare, you really don't need a tenth of a milligram scale. That is an overkill. It would be extremely expensive and you really don't need that precision. So you usually for a formulation lab, you need something about 100th of a gram, maximum milligram, but not lower than milligram. 100th of a gram would be enough. The next factor is the linearity. the linearity, if you look at this diagram, is the ability of the scale to show you the precise amount through the whole capacity. This is, look at this diagram, this is a, the actual weight that is the real weight of the object that you are weighing. This is what your scale shows you. So in an ideal life, I mean an ideal situation, you must have something that, that is this green line. So it means through the whole, assume we have a balance with 300 grams. So from 0 to 300 grams, whatever object you measure, if it is 100 grams, you should read 100 grams. If it is 200 grams, you should read 200 grams. This is a, the very ideal that is non-existing. So in reality, your balance, your scales, have a little bit of a deviation. The deviation, that, that is the linearity. So you, this blue line or this blue curve is a deviation, for example, of, let's say, 0.05 grams. This means that from 0 to 300 grams, whatever you weigh has a precision of plus minus 0.05 grams. So that's quite acceptable. The red line is a much higher deviation or linearity. You see how much deviation the scale shows. This is something about, let's say, 5 grams. So by 300 grams, if the linearity is about 5 grams, this means that if you are weighting something for 250 grams, it should be plus minus 5 grams. It varies between 245 to 255. And this isn't quite acceptable. So linearity is the characteristic that you can see on the product description. Besides or right after precision and capacity, the linearity is mentioned. And usually the lower the linearity, the higher the precision, the price is higher, but the scales are exacter. This is the kind of exactness and not the precision. Units of measurement is another factor that you have to consider. Most of you are living in areas where you have to do with ounces and pounds in your daily life, but in your formulation labs, still I recommend working with grams, which is more precise. So it's something that you have to consider before purchasing your balance, which units of measurement are available at all. Pan size and pan shape are other factors that you want to consider before purchasing your scales. Pans are usually available in rectangular or in circular shape. Unfortunately, I don't have any here available in circular shape, but this is a circular pan. But the size is very important. You obviously cannot use a vessel that is bigger than the pan or covers all of the pan, because that reduces the precision. So depending on the instruments, the vessels that you work with, and the capacities, you might choose one scale or the other one. So obviously you cannot use a 600 gram beaker here, it doesn't work. Construction material of the pan and the ease of cleanliness is a very important factor in your laboratory. You can't work not messy. It is inevitable that you spill something, and it is quite comfortable if you can clean the pan. So these are stainless steel, and these pans, you can remove them quite easily and then clean them with wet wipe or with a wet towel, or even disinfect them with alcohol, and then clean around the pan, and then put the pan easily where it is. So it is very comfortable. Then even here with this bigger one, I can easily remove the pan and then replace it. So it's quite comfortable. There are other scales where the pan is made of polymer or plastic. They work perfectly as well, and usually you can clean them. I'm not sure if you can remove the pan. Read that in the description box when before you purchase your scales or call your vendor and ask them about more information. But the fact with those polymer and plastic-like pans is that they, after a few months, you have flakes and scales overall. Specifically, if you are working in a laboratory with colorful material, with plant extracts and colorful oils, after a couple of months, you will have scales overall. They wouldn't impact the function and the precision of the scales and balances, but they are optically not quite attractive. Calibration of the scales is another factor that you need to consider before purchasing your scales. Most scales could be calibrated and should be calibrated in your laboratory. Let's say once in a year, twice in a year, or when you change something, when you replace or move the scales from one place to the other, you need the calibration. This is a part of your GMP program and should be mentioned in your GMP plan. Have a look at the description and find out whether the scales could be calibrated by you or not. Some vendors sell or claim that the scales could be only calibrated by them. This means you have to pack the scales once in a year, send them to the vendor, they will calibrate the scales for you and ship it back to you. It is quite impractical and it is quite expensive. It's crazy. It doesn't work. Or you have to call the company and they will send somebody to your lab for the calibration, and that is quite expensive as well. So purchase scales that you can calibrate in your own lab. For calibration, you need some standard weights. You cannot just use any object that you know how much it weighs for the calibration. And each scale, depending on the capacity, needs specific weights for calibration. These are quite pricey, very expensive, and if you have to purchase them separately. Have a look if you are going to decide between several scales and they almost have the same properties. The one that comes with the calibration weight is more acceptable because you don't need to purchase these weights separately. Keep in mind that you shall not touch these weights with your fingers. Always gloves to handle them. Most of you ask whether you need trade approved scales. Trade approved scales are calibrated and tested by a governmental body such as Standard Institute of your country or a trade organization of your country, and they are a must if you are selling products by weight. For example, if you are a butcher and are selling meat, sorry, vegan friends, if you are a grocer and are selling open sugar or are selling vegetables on a farmer's market, your scales should be trade approved. For your formulation lab, you usually do not need a trade approved scale, and those trade approved scales must be calibrated by the authorities, I think, at least once in a year. But you don't need them for your formulation lab, and the price is quite different and much higher if you have a trade approved scale compared to the conventional scale. Response time and stabilization are other factors that you need to consider. Usually today, almost all of the scales, even the cheaper ones, have a fast response. The response time is the time that you put something on your pan till the display stabilizes and shows you the weight. I have worked during my student time in the university. I have worked with scales that you could put something on the scale and wait for the scale, for the display to stabilize. And it took an eternity for the displays to stabilize. But today, almost all of them are very fast. Still, it can be that you stumble upon an older model, a second-hand model, or something like that, and that the stabilization time is very long. This is usually they don't mention it in the description, but if your product has a refund and guarantee, then if you see that it takes a long time, it is something that you might consider to send the scales back, because it's quite unnerving if you are working every day with the scale. Power supply is another factor that you need to consider. I personally recommend that you purchase something with a plug-in supply, so something that is suitable for your area and for your electricity. These scales that do not come with a power supply and they work only on battery modules, they are quite expensive over time and not practical. Unless you are a wandering vendor and want to go from door to door, or you have many workshops where you don't know where you are going to use your scales, if you are placed in a certain laboratory and for your own laboratory, it is always recommendable to use something that comes with a plug-in that is works with electricity. If you have scales that are, or want to purchase scales that work on battery modules, then make sure that you can turn off the energy saving modules. Nothing is as unnerving as when you are weighing something and the scale decides to go into energy save modules and turns off. That is quite, that runs you crazy over time. So if you are purchasing something that has a battery working, look that if you can turn off that energy saving function. The last but not least factor is the simplicity of working with the scales. Scales are unbelievably complicated and variable today. You have some models that measure the humidity, some models that can count pieces, some that you can weigh living pets with them. Purchase what you really need. The less knick-knack in the scales model, the longer it will work, and the better it will work, and the simpler it will work. So if you are just making small batches of some cosmetic products, you actually don't need a model that can measure humidity or count pieces. For example, in your cosmetic lab, you usually do not need something that prints. Printing function is costly, increases the price, increases the maintenance costs, and these are these knick-knacks that are additional that might sound very, very fanciful and very modern. They will just run you crazy over time if you don't need them. So just purchase what you need. The simpler, the better. So bonus to our discussion, I'm going to give you a few tips how to get the best out of your balances and how to work with them so that they hold for an eternity. The most important thing in maintenance of your pans is putting them clean. You cannot avoid spillage. It is impossible. When you are working, you have now and then some spillage. But if you choose the right model, you can easily clean the pan and the scales with a wet towel, or you can disinfect even the pan with alcohol or with other disinfectants, so they work an eternity for you. Keep your scales on a heavy and stable counter. Usually there are specific tables for scales. They come with a granite surface, but they are extremely expensive and they are an overkill if you are not doing analytical laboratory. So for your usual lab, it's enough when you have a counter that is heavy, that is stable, and that doesn't shake easily. Keep your scales away from heat sources, from moisture, from air turbulence and circulation, and from magnetic field. This means do not put your scales directly near your hot plate or your oven or your stirrer or a magnetic field, a magnetic stirrer, or somewhere when it is exposed to air, when the window is open or when the door opens, that it's directly exposed to air. These are factors that help you get the best results, the most precise results, and that help you maintain your scales for an eternity. Now, another tip for you. Most of our bottles come with a kind of dropper, with an external head that is a dropper, and that helps you dosing your liquid very easily. You actually have control over how much you are weighing. This is extremely important when you are weighing small quantities and you are working with small batches. For some liquids that you purchase by other vendors or even some of our ingredients, we don't have these stoppers. And that is rather difficult to control how much you are weighing. So one way that most of you use is just doing this. And this is first very messy, and second, you don't have any control over what you are weighing. My tip is use a kind of spatula or even a spoon. Put the mouth of your bottle on the spatula and then drizzle the liquid over the spatula to the beaker. With this method, you have an exact control over the quantities that you are using. I can literally pour the liquid drop by drop into my beaker without messing around and without spilling the liquid all over or without overdosing. So, these are my tips for you. One question that I have to answer, somebody has asked me if the brand is important when purchasing your scales. It is important. There are companies that are on the market over hundreds of years. The best names are Sartorius, Ohaus, Mettler, or Kern. But if you have the choice between a brand that doesn't cover all of your requirements and a non-brand balance that covers your requirements, then go for the one that covers your requirements. The capacity and the precision are the most important factors, even more important than the brand. If you are going to choose between an expensive brand that doesn't cover your requirements and a non-brand that covers your requirements, go for the non-brand and choose it. Don't purchase your scales on Amazon and eBay. There are overall online vendors for scales with specialists that can help you. Call them, no matter if you are purchasing 100 euro scales or 5,000 euro scales. Most of them, they are happy to serve you, to give you information, and they can give you tips that you purchase the right one, the right scales that work for your requirements for a long, long time. I hope I could have covered all of your questions. If you have further questions, just drop them per mail, Facebook, or under the comment below, and I'll come back to you. And I wish you happy weighing and happy mixing. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like the video. Thanks for joining me. Bye bye.